everybody, welcome. This is your Maestro Scoping Live from Paris. We're inside the Eiffel Tower and we are going up. So this did not go out on my Twitter feed, sorry about that. It was a Twitter error. So if you guys could share this to Twitter, that would be awesome. The tower was actually closed yesterday during the concert, but it is open today. With the fan zone going on. Wow. We've got the window. We're in the Eiffel Tower. We're in the lift right now. We just left the first floor, and now we're going up to the second floor. All right. So here we are. The highest floor is the third floor. So you have the ground floor, the first floor, the second floor, and the third floor. And there we are, guys. This is the view. Look at that. There's the river. And what's nice from up here, which is hard to see from down there, you can see how the river actually curves around the center. So it actually meanders all around the city. Over there we have the, let's zoom in. You have the giant Ferris wheel. Okay. Kimberlina in the house. You love the view. You were there in 2004. We can see over here, we see the Invalides. Okay. We're going to be able to see the fan zone in just a minute where we were. And now look, the boats. The flooding has receded and the boats are back on the river, going up and down the river. Romania almost got you, Euro. Oh no, it's scary. So, and that's, look. That's the view from the second floor looking up. We still got a ways to go to get to the very top. And then on the first floor, we'll go down in a second. There's souvenir shops here on the second floor, and there's a nice restaurant down on the first floor. It's scary. It is pretty scary. Ooh. You want to be very careful not to drop your phone, because then it's goodbye phone. The fan zone looks good on television too. It does. But you notice what's nice about from the view up here is, look at that. You get a really good sense of the Parisian architecture, how important trees are. You see, we have trees just everywhere. Trees, trees, trees. You ate at the Jules Verne restaurant. Yeah, that's a nice restaurant. So this side, now we can look at the fan zone. So do you see that fan zone over there? That's people. See all those little dots there? Those are people. And look how giant the screen is. So you can see the screen is huge. We'll do a little zoom. That's where I was a minute ago. The stadium is far from here. The stadium's over at the Stade de France. We won't even be able to see it. But that is people. There's green all around. There's trees, there's bushes, huge parks. Green, green, green. So you have all these wonderful buildings with amazing architecture, and yet you've got all these green buildings around. France versus Romania, yes. Photographer down. And look, they've lit up the Eiffel Tower now. Look at that. The Eiffel Tower is lit up. Remarkable engineering for the time this was built. This was built for the World's Fair in 1889. It was actually built as a temporary exhibit. But fortunately, they changed their minds and they decided to keep it. And now it is the iconic symbol of Paris. Look at that. That's the fan zone, guys. We're looking down at the fan zone. And we see a lot of French people, a lot of Romanians, and a lot of all kinds of other Europeans down there. Originally, they hated it. That's true. And look at this. You get to see all of Paris. It's really quite an amazing view from up here and out. So the reason why it cuts in and out is there's a lot of people there using that bandwidth, okay? So it's really hard. Yesterday I was doing the David Guetta concert, and it was really hard to do. So I don't know how many people are there, but it looks like, you know, definitely thousands, maybe tens of thousands. So yeah, David Guetta was amazing, as he is always. On this side of the Eiffel Tower, we can see the river once again. You can see the grass, and you can see this football pitch down there. So that is a sports facilities for the public to use there. There's also a pool and other stuff. I've scoped from there many times. It has a nice gym and all that type of stuff. And then, of course, wow. I can tell when we're close to a goal because I can hear the crowd screaming, "You like potatoes, or is that potatoes?" And look, the river is back. We got boats going up and down on the river again. It is not busy on the tower today. Usually this is packed, but we know we got 80,000 people in the stadium. Apparently we got another 95,000 over there in the field. You've been up the CN Tower. I've been up the CN Tower too. CN Tower is amazing. That's in Toronto. That's 555 meters tall. And for a short while, it was the world's tallest freestanding structure. What, this scope, you mean, or the previous scope? I don't even know which scope you're talking about. Halftime at the football and no goals. On the main pin, can you film down, please? Yeah, we're gonna film down right now. Hello from previous scope. Oh, the one I ended. I wish I had known that. Oh well, there is, look at it. That is the fan zone for the Euro 2016. Is that amazing or what? So apparently there are 95,000 people there. Vive la France. Is that an amazing view or what? Can you see the Stade de France from here? You cannot see the Stade de France. You can see a lot of things, but the Stade de France is pretty far. You can see the giant Ferris wheel. All right, we're having a hard time here getting the connection back. China.